We're going bigger! Let's yes. go!
Today's topic is levitation, and we're gonna use it to make this water bottle soar through the air. Wait a second, how will you make an object fly? All we have to do is overcome the weight, the force pushing down. That's mass times gravity. If we can get a force to push up that's greater than its weight, then this object will soar through the air. And if you can get them to be balanced, then you have levitation. So today, I've got YouTube sensations, Collins and Devan Key on the show, and we're actually gonna show you how you can take this impossible topic and make it a reality. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, and today's secret ingredients, liquid nitrogen and Newton's third law of motion. Oh, wait, what is Newton's third law of motion? Imagine a frictionless environment, like two friends playing around on an ice rink. If one of them snuck up behind the other and decided to push them from behind, guess what happens? The one being pushed does slide forward, but the one who did the pushing from behind also starts sliding backwards. This is Newton's third law of motion in action. If object A exerts a force on object B, then object B also exerts an equal and opposite force on object A. In this case, the equal and opposite force is what causes object A to slide backwards on the ice. See, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Now that we understand what Newton's third law of motion is, let's see the science in action. Armed with some liquid nitrogen and some water bottles and the kind city of Thousand Oaks for shutting down the fairgrounds for us, we decided to take this experiment outside because even though we knew they were gonna fly, we had no idea where they were gonna land.
We're super excited to be here today. We heard that we're like launching some bottles and just yes. making things disappear.
Side.
Whoa! Wow. You probably have a few questions, so let me explain what's going on. Liquid nitrogen has a boiling point of minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit. That's right, it's transforming from a liquid to a gas at minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit. So at room temperature or outside, it's rapidly expanding to a gas. It's also less dense than water. So when I added this to this bottle, it was sitting on top, rapidly transforming to gas, which is not a problem because the gas was escaping through the top. I'm gonna cap this just to show you what happens. When I flipped the bottle over, because it was less dense, the liquid nitrogen rose to the top of this water, but it was still rapidly transforming to gas. That gas expanded, forcing the water down. By pushing the water down, the water bottle and its contents were pushed up with Newton's third law of motion. And then you have a liquid nitrogen water rocket.
Okay, we're good. Ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1.
Woo!
Best yet. We're going bigger?
We're going bigger.
We're going bigger! Let's
yes.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed taking an impossible topic of a water bottle floating in the air and making it possible through science. And if you did, let me know. Click the like button and share this video with your friends. And if you want to learn about more of our goofy experiments, then make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that notifications button. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.